No, I think the biggest thing is to, you know, get to know everybody quickly as possible. Get out there and explain more or less how I see things, and you know, to also be very aware of the continuity that's necessary, not to throw everything at them from the start, at the players from the start, and yeah, it's a short period to prepare, in a short period to prepare. No, ovviamente una squadra che io non voglio subito dire davanti a tutti come siamo, perché c'è un po' di sorpresa, perché credo conta a nostro favore il fatto che non tutti sanno cosa devono aspettare. Per quello cerchiamo ovviamente di prendere una DNA nostra più prima possibile. Ovviamente, come appena detto, è una periodo molto breve per mettere tutto a posto, così cerchiamo anche di sfruttare dalla continuità della Coppa del Mondo. Sergio veramente ha fatto un gran lavoro, era sempre un leader speciale a Rugby in Italia, ha fatto ovviamente 5 Coppe del Mondo, è veramente un complimento anche per qualsiasi giocatore che ha giocato così tanto. Lui è veramente una persona, un esempio per i ragazzi che giocano adesso, e quando lui sarà coinvolto al fine della Sei Nazioni e per dare il suo ultimo spinto in questo movimento italiano, dare il suo massimo per far vincere la squadra e non solo un addio, lui viene veramente di contribuire per l'ultima parte, per l'ultima volta in la maglia azzurra. Yeah, I think there will be a lot of continuity. I think Wayne is very smart in the way he goes about things. He spent 5 years in Wales himself. I mean, there's a reason why they've linked him off to Warren. So it's going to be, I think, a lot of again a big physical challenge. But I do think they'll bring a little bit of an attacking edge. I think World Rugby is leaning a little bit more towards a little bit more of ball in hand approach going into the 2023 World Cup. So I'm definitely the style that Wayne's played in the Scarlets will be noticeable in the new approach.
Do you think that might make it a good time to play them, the fact that they might be trying to implement a new style, and in terms of expects a few bumps in the road and make the new
heroes? Look, I'm not going to walk into that trap. It is true that there is change. We also have change, and yeah, there will be bumps in the road. But I don't think it's ever easy to play Wales in the Millennium Stadium. Doesn't matter. And you know, after the performance into the semi-finals of the World Cup, it's going to be a proud team running out there for the first game in the Six Nations. So we expect them to be as tough as ever.
About Jake Fletcher, obviously, as Sergio Pre said, you have one final swan song, but certainly Jake looks like he will be a go-to man, certainly as a ball carrier. Can you explain to me or talk to me about his qualities, what makes him so special as a ball carrier?
Yeah, obviously, I think if you follow the Gloucester's performance and the way, he's been out for a bit, but the last couple of weeks, the way he's gone around the park with the ball in hand is exceptional. He's a very explosive player. He's very good in front of the contact and in the contact, and yes, he's also a very good defender, and he plays quite to the ball, which means that he will bring something. But hopefully, you know, there's going to be a little bit of change in the approach from all the loose forwards in our system. So it's going to be a nice challenge for all of them to work hard to get into the plan that we have to go forward. Sergio will form part of the last part of the campaign for a number of reasons. First of all, a lot of people would think that it's a last opportunity for him to say goodbye, but it's not the approach. Our approach is, he also said it, that he wants to come and contribute for last time. So we expect and the challenge is out there for him to come and be his best he can be for one last time, and in the Italian jersey. So it's not just a we're here to say goodbye attitude that he's following. It's obviously he wants to come and have a very good last game and contribute as much as he can to leave that last footprint that's needed and the example set up to now to just back that up. Sì, sicuramente ci sono tanti che hanno cambiato subito le sue squadre verso I giovani, verso il gruppo diciamo 2023. Noi, io penso dove il rugby in Italia è adesso, dove abbiamo bisogno anche le esperienze da quello che hanno giocato negli scorsi 4 anni, il gruppo che sono andato a Coppa del Mondo scorso anno hanno avuto tante esperienze, ma ci sono anche qualche giovani che nell'ultimo paio di anni Italia Under 20 hanno già mostrato, loro hanno l'abilità di vincere anche partite importanti, per quello qualche giocatore di loro deve essere anche coinvolto nel nostro processo, ma per adesso dobbiamo avere la miglior squadra per questa sfida di 6 nazioni a disposizione e quello deve essere da lì dobbiamo trovare il bilancio tra esperienza e ovviamente con questi nuovi giocatori che magari può far parte.
Ci siamo ritrovati dopo appunto un primo raduno un paio di settimane fa e già con le idee un po' chiare su quello che andremo a fare e un gruppo come diceva Franco è composto da giocatori d'esperienza, ma tanti giocatori giovani che hanno portato orgoglio, entusiasmo, vivacità all'interno del gruppo e comunque è ciò che ci serviva. Veniamo anche dalle franchigie, comunque da un periodo abbastanza positivo, quindi questa è un'aria positiva che viene portata anche all'interno dell'ambiente della nazionale. Siamo entusiasti del nuovo lavoro e c'è qualche novità per cui questo porta molta fiducia e confidenza in noi stessi. E sì, adesso abbiamo un paio di settimane o meno per preparare questa prima partita e ogni giorno dobbiamo sfruttarla al massimo per immagazzinare ciò che ci viene proposto, ritrovarlo, farlo nostro per iniziare a competere a questo grande torneo.
Sì, ovviamente di dire quanto è difficile perché non è difficile da misurare quello, ma sicuramente io come Eddie ha detto e sono d'accordo con lui, scorso anno abbiamo visto squadra in preparazione per la Coppa del Mondo in un torneo e durante il torneo tu avrai un gioco completamente diverso da di solito, per quello adesso come lui dice giustamente c'è 4 nuovi allenatori con Eric e Gregor che sono già allenatori che pensano un po' diverso sul gioco. Questa è l'opportunità nei prossimi 4 anni di alzare il livello di sfruttare delle atleti che abbiamo. Io penso atleticamente giocatori di rugby possono ancora crescere tanto e quello è una cosa specifica credo noi in Italia dobbiamo lavorare. Every game is important for us. I think a lot of people would think that Scotland and Italy is maybe teams that every time come close and there's opportunity for an upset, if I can call it that. We wouldn't like to focus just on Scotland. We would like to start this campaign and first of all follow the new processes that's been put in place. Second of all is to find our DNA and play to our strengths first. So that's going to be the first part of the objective in this competition. I think there's a lot of good work done through the Conor O'Shea era that we can just bounce on. So for us to aim just at the sides like Scotland would be misinterpretation of what we're trying to do. We need now to install these new processes and follow that to see if we can't be at our best as quickly as possible.
We'll play our game for win, that's true, and we are building our confidence in the new process. And we want to be the best that we can be. And this is our goal for these Six Nations.
Privilege of coaching against them when I was with South Africa in 2017. And I know what the French team's about, but also with a lot of new ideas coming in from Fabian will make a big difference. A lot of young players. now getting a chance. We know that the French under-20s in the last three World Cups were basically unbeaten, very strong in what they did. So that is this generation coming through. So we expect a very determined group of players. We expect a lot of liberty in play, but also with Sean Edwards being there that to help the defense, it's going to be very direct and a lot of physical stuff, which were not usually seen by the French players. So we expect really a very competitive ball in hand approach, but also a very physical defense approach.
Diciamo in termini generali o per una nazione in particolare? Diciamo che ogni squadra ha ovviamente dei giocatori chiave che la rappresentano con un'influenza particolare, per cui ripeto, ogni squadra ha un giocatore, forse non solo uno, però più giocatori importanti. Johnny Sexton. Per la Francia sono molto, come dire, vedere il discorso della nuova prima linea, nuovi giocatori, quindi Camille Chat, il tallonatore, e anche Julien Marchand che rientra da un infortunio importante, e la leadership da Wyn Jones nei confronti del Galles è indiscussa, e Owen Farrell per l'Inghilterra senza ombra di dubbio. Scozia, giocare contro le francesi scozzesi è sempre molto emozionante, un pack molto duro, però Stuart Hogg in questo momento, anche il grado di capitano che gli sono stati assegnati e per il modo in cui gioca in questo momento, sì, assolutamente un leader.
Yeah, look, I grew up with the Five Nations first. It was always a huge thing in South Africa. You know, that was our point of reference for a long time. And once it became Six Nations and 20 years ago now, obviously it was the trendsetters in the way World Rugby was approaching the new law changes. And there was always something special about the environment, the climate conditions that influence the game. So there's a lot of things that we took back in South Africa and looked at and developed our game around to be competitive, especially at the end of the year tours that we often had to come down and learn the hard way over here. I think this tournament, with the help of the very competitive domestic competitions that's around, has developed players and coaches in such an extraordinary way that they are the trendsetters at this stage in World Rugby. So for us, from a South African point of view, or from me, from a South African point of view, and from my experience from Super Rugby, it's important to find maybe a blend from South African perspective between managing the conditions and having the ball in hand, one more try approach that sometimes happens down south. We need to. I think that with the way the pitches has developed and the roofs that's closed now and then, that the ball in hand approach from a lot of teams over the last couple of years, I think from the Joe Schmidt era, especially these guys that brought something different to the game, and it showed that it can, this side of the world can also be played, not just from a kicking perspective. So I think that if I talk South African rugby, we changed our style quite a bit dramatically in the World Cup, where it was tournament competition, where it was less ball and hand approach. So we will just have to find that balance from my perspective now in Europe. What is the, well, how can we get that that perfect blend between the two, ball in hand and field domination of preterity domination components in the game? I think every year is big for Italy.
Yeah, and how do you reflect on the 20 years?
Yeah, fortunately I've spent quite a bit of that 20 years in Italy, so I've got a good perception. I know how much it means for them. I think it's there's a lot of determination, a lot of people in the rugby fraternity in Italy that absolutely loves the way that this tournament is presented, the way it's played, the aura around it. I know I was one of the big campaigners for us to become part of the Celtic League or the Pro 12 back then, and even when I played there in 2003, 2004, way back in the day, it was really, we pushed for it to become part of the Celtic League back then. So when it eventually happened, and from my perspective, since I've left Italy in 2013 until now, the Italian teams, the physicality and the rugby mindset has changed and grown a lot. I think there's a better perspective physically what's expected. Also, rugby intelligence, I think that really improved. And also, I think it became the younger generation now in Italy starts to understand what is expected of them. They start at a much earlier age developing skill sets and physical ability to be competitive. So I think the influence of the Six Nations in the last 20 years and also of pro rugby in the last 4 to 5 years will only be seen from now on.